I'm not so sure that he's just expressing himself. Whether or not God will do that is up to God. And
it's not an endorsement of retaliation per se, but it's an open, honest prayer. And even this psalm, he finishes it, from you comes deliverance, and may your blessing be on your people. So it's like he's coming back to, you know, I just vented about let's break their teeth. You should break their teeth. But he's ending with let's have blessing on the people. That's what he wants.
Exactly. And something that I've been really pondering over this last week is found in the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Really, we do have the kingdom of God, whether we're poor in spirit or rich in spirit, but we shall see God. And when we pray, when we pray through the Psalms, we can feel the Spirit of the Lord just dropping all those worries, recognizing where we're at, dropping all those worries, and coming back to a place of blessing.
Yeah, that's good.
And a recognition that salvation of where he is, where he stands with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Mm-hmm, that's good. So this week we're encouraging people to meditate on the third Psalm and to pray it as if it's their life. And I think you've done a good job of preparing people for that. Now the Psalm
is short. It's short. So yeah, do it. It's great. It's a great Psalm. It made me think. It's funny because the last month or so, I've been thinking of this song that Rita Springer sang, Arise, O Lord, demonstrate your power. And I looked it up and I was like, wow. And then I couldn't believe that here is the Psalm, that the very Psalm that I'm studying, and Arise, O Lord.
So that's Psalm 3. That's funny.
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's a mix. It's a song.
He says it a lot. Yeah.
Yeah.
Here's one of them for sure. Speaking of songs, tell us what song you picked and why.
Well, I can thank my sister-in-law, because we were in a staff meeting and I said, I don't know what song to pick. And she said, Bridge Over Troubled Water. And I was like, I do like that song. And so then I looked at it, I researched it. And of course it was, that's the song I picked, Bridge Over Troubled Water by Simon Garfunkel. Yeah. And, it's a great song. It was released in 1971. It received Song of the Year, Record of the Year, Album of the Year. And when I listen to it, I think of the singer as being Jesus.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah. We were talking earlier that that some people interpret one of the lines of that song, Sail On, Silver Girl, as being a metaphor for intravenous drug use. Like you're taking a silver needle and injecting it, and your time has come to fly, all your dreams are on their way. But you looked at that, and that's not what they're talking about.
Well, I looked at an interview by Paul Simon.
Paul Simon, yeah. And he would probably know, huh, since he wrote it.
Yes, and he said, he sort of chuckled, and he said, actually, it is a inside joke with his then girlfriend, later wife and now ex-wife, because she was
the lives of the rich and famous.
That wasn't Carol
King, was it?
No,
because I know they got married late. Yeah,
but she was fretting over finding silver in her hair, you know.
Sail on, silver girl, sail on by, sail on by. The time has come. You're going to be okay, even though. I guess we're going to be okay, even though we're apparently getting older.
Yeah.
I do have silver. Sail on silver.
I do too.
Sail on silver beard. Yeah. Sail on by. It's going to be okay.
Yes. And
so he's making a tongue-in-cheek joke toward his girl. Of course, you're hearing it, you're just like, an epic song.
It's an epic song. It's a piano-driven, beautiful song. And Garfunkel actually heard it with only two verses and said, you need to add more. And somebody else said, you need to add more. And Simon, being the true artist that he is, said, no, my song's good enough as it is. I like this short little, and it's a kind of based on he was sort of musing about gospel music at the time. And the piano player that they got to start on to kind of add his pieces was definitely a gospel, had gospel in his repertoire. And so surprisingly enough, it has the gospel aspect of it in this very beautiful rock song. And Simon finally listened to his friend Garfunkel, who is quintessential voice, and he brings a third verse into it, and he brings this big epic music, and then it just goes crazy, and it's so long that Simon thought again it's not going to work.
You gotta play it in 309 if they're gonna, you gotta write it 309 if they're gonna play it. But yeah, it's 5 or 6 minutes long, I think. Cool. Well, good choice on the song. And thank you for all these insights on Psalm 3. And you're smart and good looking. That's an amazing combination.
Oh, well, you're very smart and cute.
Oh, I was worried you would just leave it as smart. So. All right.